Coca-Cola. So guys, welcome back to Legal Vidya, and in this video we'll be studying the topic of injuria sine damno and damnum sine injuria. This topic is related to the law of torts, so let's begin. So pehle to jante hain ki legal damages kya hota hai. So in order to recover legal damages from defendant, the plaintiff needs to prove that he has suffered a legal injury because of the wrongful act of the defendant. And the defendant act has resulted in violation of plaintiff right. ये prove करना पड़ता है in order to recover legal damages. So the term injury means violation of the plaintiff's right. If due to defendant का act or any omission जो defendant ने किया है, plaintiff suffered some actual damage, but there was no violation of legal right, then the defendant cannot be made liable and no claim would lie against him. सो लीगल डैमेजेस का मतलब क्या होता है कि अगर प्लेंटिफ के एक्ट या फिर ओमिशन से अगर डिफेंडेंट का एक्ट या ओमिशन से प्लेंटिफ को कोई भी नुकसान पहुंचा हो तो वो रिकवरेबल होगा एंड दैट विल फॉल अंडर द लीगल डैमेजेस. सो वी विल बी रीडिंग टू कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ डैमेजेस. द फर्स्ट इज इंजूरिया साइन डैमनो एंड डैमनम साइन इंजूरिया. सो कमिंग टू इंजूरिया साइन डैमनम. सो इंजूरिया का मतलब एज यू कैन सी इट मीन्स इंजरी. साइन का मतलब विदाउट एंड डैमनम का मतलब डैमेजेस. So it means injury without damage, right? Injury without damage is injuria sine damno. So it means violation of legal rights without any actual harm, loss or pecuniary damage. मतलब ना injury के case में ना उसे physical loss हो रहा है, ना उसे कोई monetary loss हो रहा है, लेकिन फिर भी उसका राइट इन्फ्रेंज हो रहा है. दैट इज़ वाई एन एक्शन वुड लाई अगेंस्ट द डिफेंडेंट. इट इज़ बेस्ड ऑन द प्रिंसिपल ऑफ लॉ दैट इफ अ पर्सन एक्सरसाइज हिज राइट विदाउट कॉजिंग वायोलेशन ऑफ अदर्स राइट, देन देर विल बी नो एक्शन अगेंस्ट हिम. द मैक्सिम कवर्स द केसेस विच आर एक्शनेबल इवन विदाउट अ प्रूफ ऑफ एनी लॉस और हार्म ऑफ द प्लेंटिफ. एशबी वर्सेस वाइट इज़ वन ऑफ द मोस्ट फेमस केसेस in injurious and damno. In this case, the defendant, who was returning officer in parliamentary elections, had maliciously restricted the plaintiff from exercising his right to vote, even jabki uska naam tha voters list mein. Ab plaintiff ne kya kiya, plaintiff ne ek suit file kar diya against the defendant. Defendant ne ye bola that jo plaintiff ne action laya against the defendant, it is not maintainable as plaintiff ko koi bhi actual damage nahi hua. Matlab usse koi physical nuksan nahi hua, na uske paise gaye hai, na hi usse kahin pe chot wot lagi hai. So there is no actual damage. Court ne held kiya ki defendant is liable because the plaintiff's right to vote was infringed due to the wrongful act of the defendant. To agar aapko Ashby versus White ka case yaad karna hai, aise yaad rakho, this is voting case or election case, right? So then we'll be reading other case, that is Mazet versus Williams. In this case, plaintiff ने एक banker को sue कर दिया because he wrongfully disallowed a check presented by the customer even though there was sufficient amount in the account. It was clear violation of plaintiff right because the banker wrongfully maliciously disallowed the check. So the court held that defendant is liable even though he didn't suffer any actual damage due to the wrongful act. Then there is an Indian case of Bhim Singh versus State of Jammu and Kashmir. So Bhim Singh jo the, he was an MLA in J&K and he was arrested and wrongfully prevented from attending a session of the Legislative Assembly because of which usse vote cast karne nahi diya gaya. He was not able to cast vote. Though the person to whom he wanted to vote won, but his legal right was infringed because even after 4 days of his arrest, he was not presented before the court. Ab you must be knowing ki agar kisi ko arrest kiya jata hai, then he should be presented before the magistrate under 24 hours. Lekin yahan pe 4 din tak usse present nahi kiya gaya before the court. So the court held that plaintiff was entitled to get reasonable compensation. एंड उसे स्टेट ऑफ जम्मू एंड कश्मीर, दैट इज उसके जो भी ऑफिसर्स थे, वो उनसे कंपनसेशन मिला. कमिंग टू द सेकेंड टॉपिक, दैट इज डैमनम साइन इंजोरिया. अब हमने इंजोरिया साइन डैमनम तो पढ़ा था, जस्ट उसका उल्टा है डैमनम साइन इंजोरिया. इसका मतलब होता है डैमेज विदाउट इंजरी. इसमें डैमेज तो कॉज हुई है लेकिन कोई राइट इन्फ्रेंज नहीं हुआ है. ओके, सो अकॉर्डिंग टू दिस द डिफेंडेंट एक्ट्स हैव नॉट इन्फ्रेंज्ड एनी लीगल राइट ऑफ द प्लेंटिफ, इवन दो प्लेंटिफ सफर्ड एक्चुअल डैमेजेस और हार्म, देन ही कुड नीदर सू द डिफेंडेंट नॉर रिकवर एनी डैमेजेस. इट इज बेस्ड ऑन द प्रिंसिपल दैट मेयरली ऑन बेसिस ऑफ पेक्यूनियर डैमेजेस द डिफेंडेंट could not be held liable until it is accompanied by any legal injury or violation of a right. So basically, अगर आपको damage recover करना है तो आपको injury होनी चाहिए. अब injury का मतलब क्या होता है, अगर आपको damages recover करने हैं then you must show कि आपको एक legal injury हुई है या फिर legal damage हुआ है and your right has been infringed. Only then you'll be able to recover any kind of damages. So the case is Gloucester Grammar School case. In this case, the defendant was a school teacher who started school because of which plaintiff had to reduce its school fees from 40 pence to 12 pence per student per quarter. Though the plaintiff had suffered pecuniary damage because of the defendant, lekin there was no infringement of his right. Thus, the court held that the defendant was not liable in this instant case. Anand Singh versus Ramchandra ka case hai, in which the defendant constructed two walls on the either side of his house. Matlab uska ghar aise hai and dono side usne wall construct kiya, which obstructed the flow of the drain water, due to which plaintiff's wall was damaged and he suffered loss. In this case, court held that there was no violation of right of the plaintiff, so the defendant could not be held liable. We'll better understand the difference between injurious sign damnum and damnum sign injurious table se. Injurious sign damnum ka matlab hota hai ki a legal injury is caused to the plaintiff but there is no actual damages, that is koi bhi pecuniary loss nahi hua hai. On the other hand, damnum sign injurious ka matlab hai ki usse damages to hai, matlab usse pecuniary loss hua hai lekin koi bhi legal injury nahi hui hai. That is why it is not recoverable. So second point यही है कि injurious sine damnum के case में plaintiff is entitled to get compensation. In the other case, is not entitled to get compensation. And the third point under injurious sine damnum is it is a legal wrong for which an action can be brought against the defendant. And while it is a moral wrong for which no action can be brought against the defendant. So that's it for this video. I hope aapko ye topic samajh aaya ho. If you want the notes for the topic, do visit our website.